How do you figure out the threads on an existing cap so you can create it in CAD and ultimately make a prototype so that you can prove it out before you send it out for production? I'm going to use some tape, a piece of PVC tubing, and some Johnson's paste wax. Are you kidding me? Stay tuned, I'm going to show you how.
My name is Eric Strebel. I'm an industrial designer. Welcome to my channel about product design and making. I hope that you like, enjoy, and become a subscriber. Make sure that you hit that little bell next to the subscribe button too, in case you haven't already done so. That way you'll be notified every time I have a new video.
Add a new cutting board for the work table from Arteza. If you want to get a discount on that unit, 24 by 36, link in the description below, as well as discount on a lot of their other products. Recently, my client asked me to design a bottle that would fit with this cap. So before I could finish designing the bottle, I needed to reverse engineer the threads. And to do that, we're going to make a copy of these threads, because it's kind of hard to measure the inside of that cap. So we're going to take that cap and we are going to cast it. And to do that, we're going to plug up the little hole in the bottom of the cap, and we're going to use a piece of tape to do that. So real simple, we're just going to place that tape in the inside middle of the cap so that we don't have any material go down on the inside there and ruin the part. We're going to take a little bit of that Johnson's paste wax and we're going to wax up the threads so that the material that we use on the inside of this part to cast it isn't going to stick to it. And we're also going to wax up the piece of PVC that you saw me cut earlier on the bandsaw. Okay, it's time to get out the secret ingredient. That's the Bondo. And as your mom would say, that stuff stinks, Eric. Get that stuff out of here. Yes, it sure does. It reeks, actually. I hate using it in my shop, but it's an incredibly versatile tool. So I usually turn on the fan to draw some of the air out of the shop and keep things a little bit less toxic. I add in the cream hardener and I'm adding in some cyan toner. It's a cheap colorant, and I'm just going to add that into the Bondo. I need to mix it up really well. The beauty of adding everything in the beginning is that it all turn a nice uniform color. Just keep mixing up very thoroughly so you don't have any gray stuff left, and you get a nice uniform blue color. Of course, I added way too much hardener, which is kind of classic for Bondo. Don't add too much, you know. It'll add holes to the material. It'll add it, cause it to get too hot as well. So just be careful there. We're going to fill in the threads where we put in the piece of tape a little bit earlier. We're going to kind of pack everything in there so that the Bondo fills all the negative space really well. One of the things about using Johnson's paste wax is that for some reason, wax works really good with Bondo. It does not inhibit the Bondo. As a matter of fact, I would say that somehow it even helps the Bondo cure a little bit better, particularly against that surface where it's at. Don't know why this is or what the chemical reaction is, but it works incredibly well. Thus, the paste wax is a kind of a classic release agent that you use with polyester resin. Just works incredibly well. Now we're going to slip that PVC ring in the on the top of the cap. And you're probably curious, like, you know, we already cast the threads. Why do we need this PVC cap? Well, it's going to become obvious here in just a moment. You will see. Polyester resin is really nice in the sense that before it gets fully hard, it gets a little rubbery, and this is a great time to kind of rough trim things. It works really well. You can easily carve it or cut it with a knife or a file, in this case, before it even gets hard and fully set up, I can reverse it right out of the part and snap it out of the mold. Now you'll see why we added the little plastic PVC collar on there, and that's so that we could easily take the threads out of the cap and handle it, and just going to be much easier to remove from the part. Fits right in, it's an exact copy, and that's what we need. Now we can basically go and measure very easily the outside diameter. We can measure the thread count, and we can measure the rise of the threads so that we can build that in CAD and add it to the model that we're going to design. This, of course, is a sample CAD model that I whipped up here just for the video. These are the tops of the bottles. I can't show the entire bottle, but I did make several of them to sort of work out and tweak the threads so that the cap could screw onto it really nice.
Don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. You can click on the little icon on the bottom right of the screen to do that. You can follow me on Twitter, Facebook, and Google+. Rock on. Click here to watch some of the other design and making videos that I have. If you'd like to have your music featured in one of my videos, drop me a line.